Bilbao rhymes with wow. While the Bilbao effect has often been admired and imitated by many other cities, there's still a magic to Bilbao that cannot be duplicated. Join me as we explore this iconic city.
The world has finally opened up again, and as editor-in-chief of Metro Society, I take every opportunity to discover new places, meet new people, and explore different cultures. Join me in my journey to luxurious and meaningful experiences. This is Raul Manzano, EIC On The Move.
There are plenty of great hotels in Bilbao, but if you're looking for a place with the best location, convenience and comfort, look no further than the Grand Hotel Domini Bilbao. Situated right next to the Guggenheim Museum, the Grand Hotel Domini is also considered iconic with its architectural design. It is the first hotel to be made 100% in Spain and embodies a global hotel concept where every detail is part of the same design philosophy. Alexandra, thank you for welcoming us to your beautiful hotel.
Thank you, Raul. Yeah. Welcome. Ongi etorri in Bilbao. Yeah.
And how do you say it?
Ongi etorri.
Ongi etorri.
Yes, yes. It's in Basque.
It's in Basque, yes.
Very ancient language.
Yes, right. Can you give me a brief background of the hotel?
Gran Hotel Domine is a hotel that was born 20 years ago. Okay. The building itself, it's my family's from a long time ago, since my grandfather of German origin. Okay. He had a printing business here.
Yes.
Around the year 2000, we rented the building out and a company made this hotel.
So they put up the hotel.
And they managed it until 2015 when we took over.
Is the influence from the Guggenheim in the hotel?
Well, it's very, very important, as you can imagine, because we're directly across the street from it.
You just crossed the street. It's the best hotel here. Yeah.
And sometimes we say that it's even an extension
of the
museum because we're, of the closeness. Yeah. The location affects us in several senses, in several ways.
Yeah.
It has influenced us in the love and interest for art. We have art everywhere, as you can see here, around the common areas.
And then all the floors, the hallways have artwork. I mean, it's incredible.
The kind of clientele that comes here is very sensitive to the arts.
Yes, right.
Because they're interested in a city like Bilbao, which is very culture-oriented. We have the Fine Arts Museum 3 minutes away, the Guggenheim, and this area is called the Bilbao Arts District.
Okay, so there's like several museums in this area.
Exactly. Well, the two main ones are the Guggenheim and the Fine Arts Museum, and there are a lot of art galleries and antique stores.
It's like Madrid, that the museum triangle. Right?
Exactly, but a little bit smaller. This is one of the latest acquisitions.
Mm-hmm.
It's a piece by a Swedish group of artists. They're called Humans Since 1982.
Okay.
We discovered them in Art Basel in Miami.
Yeah.
And this is 120 clocks dancing around until at one point they form the exact time.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And it's something very special to us, and a symbol also of the new times here after the renovation, the complete renovation that was undertaken.
It's the time.
Yes, the exact time, yes.
This is such a beautiful room. You have the view of the
Guggenheim, yes, exactly.
And the bathtubs, it's the best part.
Yes, well, you can enjoy after a day of sightseeing and indulging on art and great food.
Yes.
You can just relax and take a bath. What are the views exactly?
No one can see you from down there.
No. They have a special,
glass.
Exactly.
Like a tinted glass.
Exactly.
Yeah. So this would be your standard room.
This would be a standard room, yes. Most of our rooms are about this size.
Yes.
And have these features, the decoration is very similar.
And it's very simple, you know. As you said, you want to keep the aesthetic simple.
Yes, we want it to be contemporary, timeless, no? Timeless, but everything is has noble materials, no? We have marble, that is marble. Wood, that is wood.
Not synthetic.
We don't like wannabes, we don't like fakes.
Yes, right. So
we like
here
good
materials. And it's authentic.
Authentic and always the top quality.
Your sheets are very, thread count sounds like you're in the thousand range.
I mean, it's all very, very comfy and cozy.
Yeah.
What I consider luxury nowadays is more, is location, is having time, feeling free, having space, and the hotel is very spacious, best location.
And the view.
And the luxury of impeccable service.
Yes, right. Very nice. So this is a bigger room now.
It's a bigger room. Yeah. It's the same essence, but it's a little bit different.
Yeah.
It's a junior suite, not facing the Guggenheim, facing Lersundi Street.
Yeah.
And then some elements of decoration, hardwood floors.
The usual, awesome. Real wood.
Yes, these are different views. These are city views.
Yeah. Another nice room, Alexandra.
I'm glad you like it, Raul.
Yeah.
It was a studio suite, a larger suite.
Yeah.
Also overlooking the Guggenheim Museum with a very spacious terrace.
Yeah.
Nice artwork. Very nice hardwood floors. And and a style that, as I said, is timeless, understated luxury.
Yeah.
Very comfortable,
So I've heard about this Guggenheim effect. What is that about?
Everything kind of started with the local government teaming up with Norman Foster to do a metro system of the city.
Okay.
And then the government also talked to the Guggenheim Foundation
to put the museum here.
To try and bring the museum here.
Yeah.
And then many other things have happened.
Yeah.
Many other, this hotel exists, others, part of the university is placed right here, which wasn't.
Yeah.
Around here, there was absolutely
nothing.
It was a very sad area, very very industrial.
Yeah, yeah.
This new Bilbao,
and
this area specifically, is called the Bilbao effect. Now, this amazing transformation from industrial to culture service oriented.
So now we're going to see your biggest room here now.
Yes, it's the penthouse suite. Let's
go. Let's go. Alexander, so this is your biggest room.
Exactly, this is a penthouse suite, about 80 square meters approximately.
Yeah. Again, the usual way, it's very understated.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. We try to be as close as home as possible, so they feel very, very comfortable. And this room is great because of its size, its versatility, because you can have even a meeting or a comfortable, intimate lunch here.
Mm-hmm. And then you have, again, the terrace outside.
Of course, a large, very large terrace.
And
important
artwork. This is, again, a mariscal.
Exactly. Here we have several mariscal pieces.
That's all mariscal.
The prints and then the canvases of two different time periods. That it kind of symbolizes the old Bilbao.
The old Bilbao, industrial. Really.
Yes, and this could even play with our past as a printing company.
Yes, that's very right,
And here we have some art pieces in the library and original sculptures and catalogs of exhibits around us. etc.
So walking down the hallway, we saw that the doors also are very different. Each door is different. That's also by Mariscal.
Yes, yeah. Javier Mariscal considered the doors also
art
pieces. Yes, exactly, yeah. They're all different.
Yes,
they have different types of wood.
Yes,
that
right.
Put together,
in
make
different angles and everything.
Exactly.
So even the door is an artwork.
Exactly.
The hallways are artwork. So that's really amazing. I mean, you know, you combined art, culture into the hotel. Thank you again for having us here. But the most important part, I want to go to the rooftop.
Of course.
Then we can see the museum from there.
It's the jewel.
Yes. So Alexander, we're on the rooftop. This is like the gem of the hotel. But I know you have different gems along in the hotel, but this is the $1 million view.
Exactly, yes. Exactly. That's what everybody wants to come and experience here at Domine, because we have 180-degree
view
of the new Bilbao.
Yes, right.
Because as I said, there was nothing here before.
It was industrial, yeah.
It was very industrial, and now it's the center of, you know, of
arts and culture.
Arts, culture.
Renewals.
Exactly.
So we have the Guggenheim here that's done by Frank Gehry.
Exactly, Frank Gehry.
This and place also attracted a lot of other architects to come here.
Yeah. Yes, yeah. In this new area in Abando Ibarra, we have many of the Pritzker Prize winners, architects present here. Like that cube over there is made by Rafael Moneo. It's part of the University of Deusto.
Yes.
The big tower by Iberdrola is César Pelli.
César Pelli. Yeah.
The Bilbao effect, the Guggenheim, the metro, and then everything kind of followed. Everything followed.
And then you have a beautiful promenade there in the bottom, right?
It's a very nice place to walk around, surrounded by art.
Alexander, thank you so much for taking us around your beautiful hotel.
Thank you very much for coming, Raul.
Yeah, no.
You know where you have your home now, and the entire team here in Bilbao.
This is our home now. I'm planning to come back, and this is the only hotel I'll stay in because it's right beside the museum.
I'm very glad you liked it. Thank you very much for coming, and don't forget to check out our new wellness and our lobby bar 61.
Okay, perfect.
I think you're going to like them.
Muchas gracias.
Muchísimas gracias.
Thank you.
Common to every city in Spain is the old town, and in Bilbao, this bustling sector is a rich mixture of everything food, culture, and people all in one area. Joining me on this trip is Chef Margarita Fores, 2016 Asia's Best Female Chef. She has visited this city many times, once in 2004 and again in 2018, taking part in the world's 50 Best Awards. We both met David, our tour guide, who will show us through the old streets of Bilbao.
This has been here for a long time, this shop.
So all they do is make hats.
Yeah, that's right. They sell these kind of traditional wool hats because the traditional beret should be wool.
They're so nice.
This is a man from Bilbao. This is a woman. And this is a man. Okay, very different.
Okay.
Very different. Yeah, so different.
This is beautiful.
It's so refreshing.
It's nice and cold.
The architecture here is much older than the facade of the church. And like we can see that now, like the structure is lower, the stones are a little bit more worn.
This market was an old market, but it looks very redeveloped, right?
That's right. Yeah, this was the original market square of Bilbao.
Yes.
And in the 1920s, they finally gave them a covered market. The market sellers
was open.
That's right. Yeah, but they were sick of getting wet. They were always getting wet, so they built a big covered market. So this the building's from the 1920s, but recently they've redeveloped it. So most of what we see inside is new.
It's a wonderful renovation because they've maintained like old touches. Yes, the railings are still intact.
The ceiling
with the stained glass. So
let's go look at the stalls.
Let's go,
Margarita.
Shall we?
Don't go crazy.
I know, my eyes.
Fish and seafood here from the Cantabrian Sea, North Bay of Biscay. But of course, these days it comes from all around.
But beautiful. Unbelievable.
There, and the Lugina, that's something I've already seen. So, this was built in the 19th century, so it's not as old as some of the parts of the
problem. What is Pinchos and what do the Spaniards do?
Okay. Well, here in the north, the traditional kind of snack food, or maybe a little bit of an aperitivo before lunch, is pinchos.
Okay.
Maybe in other places they have tapas, but here in the Basque Country, it's called pinchos. That's right. And the traditional things are ham, like we have here. I love tortilla de patatas, you know, the Spanish omelet. And because it's the Basque Country, you'll also find fish as well.
Yeah.
Things like tuna, maybe a little bit of cod, something like that.
And Margarita was saying that they also experiment with new kinds of pinchos.
It's like there's a tradition, but there's also all these experimental things with the foie gras or something with, you know, like I was just reading, there's like this thing of oxtail with an orange sauce. So very, very interesting to kind of like, you know, enjoy the tradition and then also
try something
enjoy
new.
The hipster.
Yeah, there's all these wonderful flavors in the world. So why not try new combinations?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Salute. Okay, Margarita, you're the girl, you try first.
Ooh, it's a big wad of jamon, huh?
Yeah.
So my neighbor, my old neighbor where I live, he makes chacolí.
Oh,
and
really?
I said to him, what's the difference between chacolí and vino blanco, white wine? And he said, chacolí is the white wine we make here.
Yeah, okay. What's on board?
Delicious. Have one, David. Oh, it has tomato underneath. So it has the grated tomato paste.
Wow. So
very good. Nice.
Architect Philippe Starck brought wit and humor to architecture and interior design back in the 90s. He envisioned a space where the arts and events community could come together. This is the Azkuna Centroa, an art haven with the intention to share the best of what Bilbao has to offer for the arts and culture.
Raul, Margarita, thank you for coming. It's a pleasure to have you now. And if you want, we can go and visit Azkuna Centroa. Yeah.
Thank you for having us, Barbara.
We're so excited to see what's inside.
Okay, so let's go. We have big buildings here inside inside the city with these magnificent columns.
Yeah.
We have 43 magnificent columns that represent the different civilizations in the world.
Wow. Oh, and that's why they're all different.
Yeah. Yes, they are all different because everyone is different, but all together we build a community.
Yes.
So this is why each of them are made with different materials, and they are also inspired of different historical cultures. Yeah. And they're all made by artisans.
Yes.
And all the building has been transformed by Philip Stark.
Oh my God, so it's okay. Philip Stark.
Yes. All together, we can see their diversity, their different backgrounds, but it is also the sense of the respect to the culture, respect to the society, and there are many values inside there.
And then culture brings them all to one.
All to one,
yeah.
Correct. This is why this center tries to connect the society and the culture, society and contemporary culture.
Okay, we'll follow you.
Very inspiring.
Yeah.
Yes.
So Barbara, this whole center was made for the public in Bilbao, right? What was the purpose of this?
Azkuna Centroa Alondiga Bilbao is the center for society and contemporary culture.
Okay.
It owns to the municipality of Bilbao.
Yes.
And it was, its concept is for all the society, not only for the public of Bilbao, but for all the audiences.
I mean,
it's for the professionals that are visiting us, for the tourists, for the people from Bilbao, for the artists.
Yes, right.
And here it opens every day of the year.
Okay, even Sundays.
Even Sundays. Even Christmas.
Oh, that's amazing. Even Sundays.
Yeah.
Yes. And it is a place where we organize and we produce many cultural programs as exhibitions. Mm-hmm. As a film and audiovisual program, also in live culture, also live arts. So there are a big program for artists in residence.
In residence,
So we have different combat calls for them during the year with different disciplines.
Yes.
And we also have a big mediatek, a big library.
Okay.
Where we organize many conferences regarding the literature, but also a big festival called Gotum Surya. This is an international festival of literature also, but also regarding comics.
Including comics.
Yes, actually we have a residence for comic with an international with France and with Canada and Quebec also,
You know, a lot of good illustrators for comics come from the Philippines.
So it is the key also to promote the change in the society also. The closer you are to the culture in general, the closer you are open to the mind.
Yes.
And you are closer to the people and to the culture, and you have also an open mind.
Yes,
also.
Right.
But Barbara, after what we've seen, the space is just so inspiring. Every corner has something that's different and a real kind of incubation space.
Yes.
I think this is the only space I've seen in the world that has all the media and all the different forms of inspiring people.
And so open every day, including Christmas.
No holidays.
Yes. No holidays.
Yes, let's consume culture every day of the year.
That's a perfect line.
And let's spend our free time in a very inspiring thing.
Exactly, an inspiring space.
Yes.
Gracias,
es que
Barbara.
Thank you so much for taking us around this wonderful art space.
Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Another integral museum to the city is the Bilbao Museum of Fine Arts. Spanning art from the Middle Ages to the present, It was built to modernize the city and to showcase the best of Basque culture. It combines artistic tradition and history, which makes sense as Bilbao proudly wears its past. Magda, thank you for having us here in the Museum
It's a pleasure
of Fine Arts.
For us. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Yes.
Welcome to the Bilbao Fine Arts Museum. Yes. You are in this beautiful museum, which is the Museum of the City, and was founded in 1908. Okay. So it's been running through more than a century now, time enough to be a part of the city, a very important part of the city. And time enough to have a very beautiful collection.
Yes, yes.
The collection runs from the 13th century till nowadays, with some parts very special, like the Spanish school, with names like Rivera, Goya, Sorolla, and many others. Yes. And also the Basque artists that we have, obviously, the best collection.
Yes. When will the renovation of the new museum happen?
It's scheduled to finish in 24. We have already started.
Yes.
In the old building, we have made a renovation
yes.
because the museum is not going to be closed.
Yeah, oh, so continue.
Yes, now we are working, we are receiving the visitors in this building, and now we are moving to the other one.
Yes.
Meanwhile, the main project
is being developed.
It's still going, so it's good. Now we have a selection of masterpieces of the collection, which is also a good for foreigners and visitors.
Yeah.
It's also a good worth to visit the museum because you see the highlights.
Yeah.
And also it's a very important moment because the museum is going to change in 2 years. So it's nice to be part of this important change.
What a wonderful new chapter for you.
Yeah. Yes.
Well, we're so happy to be enjoying it all in the very short stay that we're here.
We can have a walk through the collection if you want. This is this building that you can see here. And this is, you know, the statue in the middle.
Yes,
and this is going to be closed.
Yeah.
It's going to be a very big reception area. Yeah. Both buildings are going to be straight on connected. You see now that it's closed,
but
it's going to be open. And then in this structure on the top, there's going to be a very big exhibition area, offices.
That's
going
one.
Yes. It's going to be a terrace open air with a sculpture. So it's incredible,
So the water feature here, Marta, will disappear. They just keep the sculpture.
Yes, yes, because it's going to be
indoors.
Indoors, and it's going to be, you know, used for public space as well.
Look at the amazing glass.
Yes, you see here.
Yeah, here.
You see, it's not actually on the buildings, but on suspended. Yeah, it's called agravitas in Latin, which means with no gravity. Yes, and that's the whole idea. You see, this is the open air terrace for sculptures and other, you know, events or whatever you want. And this is the big exhibition area. It's going to be.
So Raul, we have to be back.
You have to be back. 24.
You have to come. You have to come. Yes, you have to come back.
And see the big difference. Right?
Yes, yes, it's going to be amazing. Yes.
Yeah.
So this is by a local artist, Dora Salazar. It's a very beautiful, sensitive, fine, and refined. Image of a woman. This is another woman. This is like the inside of this woman.
Oh, yes.
And it's by Lucas Cranach. He's a very important painter in the Northern Renaissance in Europe. And it's also a very beautiful painting, one of the jewels of the collection.
Oh, wow.
So it's a kind of welcoming to our visitors. Very beautiful, the old and the new. And here we are having a selection of just about 60 works of art, I think, more or less. But our collection is more than 14,000. Well, this is a painting by El Greco. Yes, we do have two Grecos in the collection. This is represented San Francis. And it's in the style of El Greco with very few colors, also showing the preparation. You see that this red everywhere,
yes. as an aesthetic also of the painting, and very modern way of painting. You can see these brushes, like yes, broken yeah. brushes, to give expression to the painting, and just this still life representing the crosses, the cross, the skull, this book, and this daily detail, like yes. putting a paper to mark.
And even the folds of the paper.
Yes, here. Well, this is quite common. It's the signature. Yeah, and you see here another example.
Oh, okay.
It's a trompe-l'œil. Yeah. Yeah. We use the French word trompe-l'œil yeah. to make this, you know, like, yeah. it's like,
the
you know, fix.
Yeah.
You
yes.
know, with. So it's very nice. And this is representing these votes, the poverty, the obey, and castity of the St. Francis order. So it's a,
this it's is very ungraced with the
yeah,
face.
No, and the long fingers.
The long fingers, the long
elongated
face.
Also.
Face very concentrated, very fine, and just a spot of white in the eye that gives life.
It's amazing.
So it's very, very, very clever yeah. painting and very moving painting, in my opinion.
Marta, thank you for taking us around the collection. Even though it's just a small portion, we saw a perfect mix, right, Margarita?
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. What a remarkable experience. Yeah. Really,
truly. Yeah. It's been very nice yeah. to have you here, yeah. Margarita and Raul.
Yes.
And of course, I invite all the Filipinos
yes.
to come here to the museum,
yes.
enjoy the museum, and enjoy the city.
Yeah.
You know, after what we've seen, we'd like to invite them too, because,
yeah, yeah.
I mean, you have to really experience it. It's just a must for art lovers and yeah. for people who really just, you know, want to see beautiful things.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
It's been a pleasure, and as we say in Basque, eskerrikasko.
Eskerrikasko.
Thank you. Very
much. Thank you.
Okay. Gracias.
No matter how many times you return, the Guggenheim Bilbao is still breathtaking. It broke the mold of the typical boxy museum design and created such a sensation that it put Bilbao on the map. When the museum was inaugurated in the late 90s, it liberated artists, curators, and art lovers in and outside of Spain and redefined the concept of an art space and a city landmark. We were delighted to meet Leka, Guggenheim's curator, to tell us more about the place. Leka, can you give us like a brief history of the Guggenheim?
Sure.
Okay.
The Guggenheim Bilbao was founded, well, opened in 1997.
Okay.
So actually this year we are celebrating our 25th anniversary of the museum. So it's pretty exciting for us. Mm-hmm. During this time, as you can see behind me, we've put a lot of focus on very important sculptures that are what we would think of as very singular to yes. different artists' oeuvres. And so with many of these artworks yes. that you can see on the exterior of the museum, but also inside, mm-hmm. we've worked directly with artists to think about sort of special places for these yes. artworks, site-specific works. So kind of thinking about the visitor experience
right.
and creating this really memorable time for people to see artworks that they can't see anywhere else
right.
and in dialogue with our building, which of course
yeah.
is so
against the
special
structure.
Exactly
yeah.
the building by Frank Gehry, which you know so many people want to visit Bilbao to
yeah,
see
yeah.
so it's this nice dialogue of architecture and art that we have been kind of striving to create a harmony yeah. with over the years.
So even if you don't go into the museum, you still have artwork scattered outside
yeah.
the museum, right?
Yeah, absolutely. People that, you know, live in Bilbao or come to visit mm-hmm. and aren't interested
yeah.
in coming in the museum are still going to be able to see yeah. you know, really spectacular artworks like, well, right behind me we have Jeff Koons' tulips, but out in the front of the museum we have the huge puppy sculpture.
Yes. Of course, everybody knows
yes.
the puppy.
Everyone knows, we have to take a picture
yes.
of the puppy.
Poppy is now sort of Bilbao's mascot. Okay. So when you think about, you know, New York City, maybe you think about, you know, some of the skyscraper. Well, you think about Bilbao, you think about the puppy.
So we've heard about the Guggenheim effect. How has it affected the art scene and the area, which was once a container port and an industrial area?
Yeah, the Guggenheim has single-handedly completely turned around the economy and the city of Bilbao, and even a good part of the Basque Country.
Yes.
We have a number of pieces that are site-specific that we've worked with artists to sort of determine just the right place in the museum to create an environment that's very suitable for the artworks, right? We've
like
talked about a few.
Super focused, yeah.
Exactly. One of my favorites would be the installation for Bilbao by the artist Jenny Holzer. Mm-hmm. She's an American artist and for several decades has been working with the written word, using that in her art. And so when you enter the atrium of the museum, even without going into our galleries, mm-hmm. you're drawn into this space that's sort of darkened. It's painted a certain color. And from the floor to the ceiling, which is, you know, three stories high, we have these beams of LED lights that run. And in English, Basque, and Spanish, there are these different sort of statements or declarations that she makes that are called truisms.
How many visitors come a year?
In a normal year, we have an average of about 1 million visitors.
Wow.
So we are able to really get a lot of visitors, of course, in our summer months. Mm-hmm. We just had the Holy Week vacations, yes. which a lot of Europeans travel during those times. And we're very proud. We've just opened a huge exhibition. And partly as a result of that, we just had over 27,000 visitors
wow.
from Thursday to Sunday our Holy Week
vacations. It's like everyone's on revenge
yes.
travel.
yeah. yeah.
Revenge museum.
Exactly. People are very, I think, yeah. eager to travel. Yeah. And it's such a nice destination yeah. to come for a few yeah. days. So, yeah.
Thank you so much for having us
Oh,
here.
Thank you. Yeah. It's such a pleasure.
So, yeah.
Thank you.
5 years. Yeah.
Thank you very
much.
We're
excited to go to the different galleries here.
Good, yeah. good. Well, I hope you enjoy it.
Yes. Today, we decided to take a walk with Margarita's good friend, Chef Josean Alija. He wanted to show us what he thinks are three of the best Pinchos bars in Bilbao. And if Chef Josean says it's good, we know we are in for a treat.
Aquí estamos delante de un choco. Okay. El choco para nosotros es un lugar privado
sí.
que tienes que ser socio uh-huh. y donde hoy
Sí.
Siendo socio, amigo de un socio, puedes entrar
ah, okay.
y poder disfrutar de la cocina auténtica y tradicional del País Vasco.
Okay.
So it's an eating club that's very private. You have to be a partner or a member of the association to be able to enjoy the choco. So that's what the choco means. I didn't know.
Históricamente era una herrería, un lugar donde se trabajaba el hierro.
To do metal works here before it became an eating club.
Este es uno de los tres más antiguos de toda la ciudad.
One of the three oldest. And Josean is saying that they really do the traditional Basque food in the choco.
Right.
Yes.
So the filipati is a sandwich with lettuce, anchovy, mayonesa, no?
Mayonesa.
And chili, no?
And chili.
Okay. While the other one, the bilbaíto, is two shrimps mm-hmm. on bread with hard-boiled egg,
and mayonesa.
Mayonesa, huevo duro,
yes.
y langostino.
And langostino,
yeah. Yeah. And aquí, this is also the egg.
Same.
Aquí todos. los locales entran y dicen, Patty, ¿me pones un huevo?
Oh, ah.
Se llama así, so, simple.
Así nomás.
Sí.
Okay. So they just ask for an egg and this is what they're given.
Okay.
Salud.
Salud. Salud. Ching ching.
Ching ching.
Enjoy.
Wow. When you come here and you say egg, that this is what they give you.
Please give me an egg.
This one.
Nos vamos a seguir tomando unos potes por Bilbao.
Sí.
Okay. Y probando cosas divertidas y ricas.
Sí.
Pues vamos al Belch.
Ok,
al
sí.
Belch.
Aquí tenemos Nuestra Señora, la Virgen de Begoña, patrona de Bilbao y patrona de los chiquiteros. Los chiquiteros son esas cuadrillas de amigos que van de bar en bar tomando vino y comiendo pinchos, lo que estamos haciendo nosotros. Hoy es nuestra Virgen.
Sí. Lengua.
Esto es
mano.
Ah, mano. Ah.
Mano de cerdo. El pan del País Vasco, ¿vale? Que es harina de maíz, agua y sal.
Harina de maíz, corn. Ah, corn. Esto.
Sí.
Es así.
Se llama talo.
Talo. Y se cocina en una
corn
chapa.
Flour.
Yeah.
Se cocina, se cocina en una chapa. Y este es el pan nativo del País Vasco.
So this is the typical bread.
Yes.
Basque country. It's made with corn flour, no? Harina de maíz.
Harina de maíz.
Y después agua.
Agua y sal.
Just water, salt, and corn flour. The town is just as good. With a brown sauce, super delicious. Raul, oh my God.
Bueno, ¿qué tal? Bienvenidos, mi nombre es John, estáis aquí en la Taberna Basaras. Es una tasquita clásica, se abrió en 1943. Y os puedo enseñar un poquito, nuestra barra de pinchos es algo clásico, sencillo, pero siempre intentando lucir el producto, ¿no? De aquí que tenemos, del Cantábrico, del mercado, la tenemos todo muy cerquita.
Good. It's very spicy.
He's getting his chili fix. That's why.
It's perfect with the wine. This wine. What are we eating?
A super typical pincho.
Okay.
Just with anchovies.
This, yeah.
Garlic.
And
parsley.
And parsley. Okay.
And olive oil. Oh. And vinegar.
And vinegar. Okay. Mm. Wow, fresh anchovy.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh wow.
Chef, muchas gracias.
Eskerrik asko.
Eskerrik asko. Maraming salamat.
Maraming salamat. Tagalog.
Mabuhay.
Mabuhay. Maraming salamat. Mabuhay.
Mabuhay.
En euskera, salud.
Just behind the main entrance of the Guggenheim is Chef Josean's world-famous restaurant, Nerua. The Guggenheim needed a restaurant that could live up to its legendary architecture and outstanding exhibits. And where great art resides, great food must be around the corner.
Chico.
Very chico. Mushroom.
Sí, es una seta. De aquí, local, que se puede comer cruda. Tiene aroma a harina, ¿vale? A trigo recién molido, ¿vale? Y a bosque. Bosque, montaña.
Bosque, montaña.
Y esta es la misma, pero más grande.
Más grande.
Huele.
Y también crudo.
Este es crudo, ¿vale? Este está ligeramente cocinado.
Yeah. So the mushrooms are raw.
Okay, raw.
They're from the forest.
Yeah.
And they're seasonal.
Yeah.
And it has a little bit of garlic. Yes. And the guindilla peppers.
Yes.
The little green ones.
Peppers, yes.
The kind of spicy, but not spicy, yeah. But it's more sweet.
Yeah.
Wow.
Y polen.
Y polen.
Oh, maíz y polen.
Wow.
So a sabayon of egg with polen. Ooh la la.
Oh my god. Wow. More mushrooms.
Y ahora, esto. Oler. Romper y comer.
Okay.
We mix it. Okay.
Oh my gosh.
And my mouth's watering.
I know. Actually, it's incredible to be able to enjoy it raw.
Yes.
Because it's you're not changing the flavor.
Flavors, yeah.
Or taste, masking it with, you know, oil and garlic. But
and you can taste the forest.
Yeah. Exactly.
Margarita said everything is fresh. I can taste the forest here. Really good. Right, Margarita?
We can taste the forest.
Mm-hmm.
It's such a subtle flavor, actually.
Mm-hmm.
But it's almost like you taste the season.
Mm-hmm.
And you know that this is only for a short time, yeah. Right? So.
Wow. Oh.
Balut.
Balut.
Balut. I think, Josean, you remember, no? The experience of the eating balut at farmer's market.
Oops.
Every time we see each other, Josean always reminds me.
Mientras viene Toño con el producto, esto, te cuento la historia. Esto es un plato, una idea que une Filipinas, Euskadi, y es la salsa negra, ¿vale? El estofado. Que trajeron los jesuitas de Filipinas a el País Vasco. La salsa negra la conocéis perfectamente allí, que es estofado de chipirón, vosotros le ponéis cebolla, tomate, jengibre,
ginger, yes, yeah.
Coco, vinagre de coco, pues bueno, eso es esto, unido con un producto icónico nuestro, que es el guisante lágrima.
Oh, wow. So Josean says that it's an idea
from the Philippines.
Brought, de los esuitas, no? That it's made of squid ink, but with ginger and coconut vinegar. And Josean will be serving it with guisantes lagrimas.
Again,
qué bonito. It's so pretty. I don't want to touch it.
And it's a simple dish.
Right. Yeah. It's just the guisantes. Okay. And then the sphere of the squid ink adobo. Yeah. The sprout umami.
Umami Basco.
Yeah. Umami Basco.
Basco.
So Basque umami.
Okay, you crack it again.
Okay.
There's the ink.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. Me first.
Yeah, you first. You first.
Oso koso. It's really like an intense adobong cuisine. But you can taste the smokiness of it being cooked a la brasa. So delicious.
So good.
So those are mustard seeds. And then a little mousse of idiasabal, milk.
And everything looks so delicate.
Se cocinan en la brasa con aceite de pimiento verde. Y esto es una castañuela.
Castañuela.
Sí, castañuela es una parte que está aquí en el cerdo.
And it looks wonderful. Se llama sweet bread in English.
Sweet bread?
Yeah.
Sí. Okay. So that with the mustard seeds in the bottom and the baby beans tossed in green pepper oil and then with the mustard leaves and it looks like guatucola to me, but Josean called it something different. Okay.
You mix it again.
No, I'll just take the sweet bread.
Okay.
Good.
Oh wow.
Wow. Oh la la.
Senza parola.
Yeah, wow.
Senza parola. I said no words.
No words,
No, and I love the mustasa, the spice of the mustard seed. It cuts through the richness of the sweet bread. It's so yummy. It's a modern take on the tradition of eating the hake with the red pepper, which is not seasonal. Yeah. They have it all year round. Raul, I'm so excited to break this for the two of us. Oh my gosh. Hear that crunch.
Look at it.
Yeah, and like Josean says, super simple, super classic combination of these two ingredients. That's very typical of the Basque country, but what a beautiful take on it. Okay.
He said it's like a tempura.
Yeah. He said, kind of like a tempura.
Go ahead.
Let's get some of the peppers.
Okay.
OMG. Oceano.
Bueno?
Muy bueno.
Muy.
Es que creo que tiene ya plástico más. Oceano. Muchas gracias.
That was absolutely spectacular.
No, truly.
Muchas gracias.
Yes. Sí, gracias, Oceano. Yes. And it's so nice that, Oceano gets inspiration also from other parts of the world, the squid egg that you say maybe the Jesuitas brought to the Basque country from the Philippines. That's something so remarkable, a little bit of the tempura in the meluzzo, and just everything and putting it together with the beautiful produce of the Basque country.
And in a beautiful setting.
Eskerikasko. From the heart.
Suri.
Josean. Suri.
Bilbao's charm is a timeless one. From its rich heritage of industry from the old town to its bold statements of avant-garde Spanish culture, this city is truly the beating heart of the Basque country. This is Raul Manzano, EIC on the Move.